don't remember what you had to do every single time. Let's see. We had to do buy two things, right? Oh, rainbow stuff.
He's just getting started.
I'm looking a little bright today. Stupid screen. Not bright. I'm looking a little pale. Oh. It's a little better. Jeez, how many abras do we have going right now? Yeah, I was gonna say, I think they're both fakes. It still looks really bright. I think that's just my screen over here. Really soft, but it feels really dry.
started.
Ugh, it's just so bright right now. What's new up here? I feel like I did all this. That doesn't sound... Yeah, that doesn't sound fun. Yeah, I don't want Njoku. Pretty sure I got this done. Oh, no, I didn't. I guess I can go fix my receivers now since I don't. Never mind. No. Over that. It. A big poopy. What is it now, anyway? Emmanuel Sanders should be a 97. Joe Horn should be a 97. Mecole Hardman should be 97. Josh Gordon should be a 96. Tyreek is the fifth best. What is going on? Terrible speed. I think Joe Horn's speed is actually pretty. What did I do to my team? See, his is a 95. Still low. What? Apparently I need to start getting money. I've definitely got enough training to last forever. I honestly don't feel like playing football.
Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach with you here today for another edition of Madden Ultimate Team. Let's get back to Brandon and Charles for the call.
We will begin this challenge in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining. It's a tie game, 21-21. You've got the ball on your own 25-yard line as we get set here, first and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes.
Oh, he burned him.
He's gonna rifle.
It's still backpedaling.
Got his man complete. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A great effort there. 75 yards. And the Bengals come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. Extra point up and good by Succop. And they will take a 7-point lead. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up right now. A hit and a loose football. And the Bengals have
it. Out of my way.
And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Cincinnati touchdown.
But that's got to be so disappointing for a defense. You force the fumble. Think you got a chance at a turnover, and instead, not only do you give up the football, you also give up a touchdown.
I think I should do the BioShock Infinite DLC since I get everything from the man and main.
I think they relaxed a little bit, or maybe lost their focus as well, and it ended up turning out to be a touchdown against them.
It's a squibber picked up around the 27, and they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line.
JoJo just got tackled.
The Browns drive about to get started. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for six.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it. And that's what you don't want to do.
Second down, here's Chubb again. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get in shape.
On third down, Mayfield. That one caught by Felton.
Yeah.
And he loses the football a second time. He's thankful right now for that sideline because it could have been a fumble loss, instead just a fumble, though they will have to punt it down.
You're right about that, but do you think there's ever been a player happier to see his own punter go on the field than him?
No.
I mean, not at all, right? How fortunate is he that they got chance to punt it away, and it's not just a turnover at the spot.
Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Bengals will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory.
What are we doing here?
The Bengals drive about to get going. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The 1-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
So the previous play, a big help, as now they'll have it first and 10 up at the 20. Mahomes gonna throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a...
Oh, shit. I tried to go over top, and he just...
Really
honey badgered me.
And finish this one off. exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm, they've been sharp, they've been on it, and they pick up another first down there.
Three quarters in the books. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. On first and 10, here's Mahomes going for it all. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch.
One's open.
They try to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
This one caught by Kittle. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. They continue to throw these safe passes. Who can blame them?
A loss of two there, second down.
This is obviously a critical sequence for this defense if they want to stay in this game. Down two scores already. They give up a touchdown here. That make things really difficult for their offense moving forward.
So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get your reset. They've got a second and goal now as they look to add a few more points here on. And he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. Christian Okoye taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bengals go 98 yards and finish it off in the end zone. Extra point put through by Suckup. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So that drive goes 8 plays. And it results in a 4-yard touchdown run.
Now we still need one more touchdown.
Now it's Ryan Suckup on after the touchdown to kick it away.
I think we only have like 200 yards.
Picked up around the 27. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
Pick it off.
From the gun, Mayfield, nowhere to go here.
Just fumble it and our guy will pick it up.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely.
Double covering my running back?
Right. And that
nice attempt.
Incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep playing.
He got burned, but our own guy just ran into the same route.
In jeopardy.
Open man, it's the tight end Kelsey. Touchdown Bengals. Travis Kelsey, 30 yards. And the Bengals are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Sucka, and that'll increase their lead to 28. Now it's Ryan Sucka on after the touchdown to kick it away. It's a squibber.
Boom!
Now a hit and a loose football, and the Bengals grab it, and they will take over at the 29-yard line. And that one is his second fumble loss. Not a good look out of your return man.
And not only does he hurt the momentum for his team or even change momentum of the game, but now they've got a decision to make on his own sideline. Does he continue to do that? Do you keep him in that role or do you bring someone else in at this time?
He's going to go up top for the end zone.
Touchdown.
Another six. It's caught for a touchdown.
That should be close enough.
And the blowout continues.
Probably have to play another two games.
There as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone, so give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Extra point put through by Suckup, and that will extend this big lead. Now it's Ryan Suckup on after the touchdown to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27, and they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. First down, Mayfield. That's going to be taken in by Felton. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. He's going to let it fly. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the fourth.
Now we can definitely get the yards.
Just shy of the 20. CD, this defense, man, at this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
They run on first down, but it only...
Maybe not if Koye runs like that.
It's second down now. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because... we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason.
Again, he just stood there and the guy ran by him.
The miracle of the... this is caught inside the 15. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Suck up for the extra point.
This thing is ugly.
And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The quick strike ability certainly intact there. Two plays, 80 yards to score. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the... now a hit and a loose football. And the Bengals grab it.
Times when we talk about piling on in any subject, it's a negative. In this case, for this team, it's a real positive. Just scored. Now they go down, knock the ball free, get it back. They got a chance to really increase their lead and put themselves in the driver's seat.
On the other side, a little insult added to the injury. They're in a bad spot. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They're going deep for Hill. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they are going to score again, yet another touchdown. Just add to their totals.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about
pulling the
reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not their head coach's makeup at all. I think his opinion is, you stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
What the hell?
To kick it away. It's a squibber picked up. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Bengals grab it.
And the Bengals grab it.
Finish to this ball game. There you have it. Another challenge and another victory. Now remember, you can always replay challenges if you left any stars.
Now we're
table.
Good. Maybe I'll upgrade him. I got that card a long time ago. Leg asleep. Is there even anybody in here that I want? I've always liked Mike Allstott, but it's kind of overkill now. Ooh. We like Woodson. Oh, we need a receiver. I don't even know what we're at anymore with the theme. We'd have to take a wash somewhere. Always bench Kittle. And Judy. Judy isn't really necessary anymore. And if we upgrade Okoye, we get a bonus there. Defense, that's kind of ugly. Those are all Chiefs. All Chiefs. Okay, maybe I take that back. We really replace Polamalu. And our defensive tackles, we can't do anything about. And our cornerbacks. We could wash Woodson with one of them. Nah, anyways. Yeah, I didn't think any of the cheap ones would be in here. Oh, hey.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. I'm the coach, and this is Madden Ultimate Team.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Mahomes now on first down. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek kill. 62 yards. And the Chiefs on just two plays have taken the lead. Well done. You've defeated this ultimate.
This is pissing me off.